Shannon Noll might have lost a few fans with a rendition of the national anthem. Some are describing it as the most bogan ever. Here's how he sounded at the Cox Plate race meet. And murdered the anthem. Others went further, with one post on Twitter saying, "Lucky Shannon Noll isn't a horse, because that version of the national anthem would have had him put down."
That's so mean.
And this one, "The most bogan rendition of the anthem I have ever heard." I wonder if
Marsha,
it's just
you've created a monster.
Now look, you know, I knew. I mean, no pressure.
Is this a sound problem though? It sounds like the mic's off.
Okay. That is one of the hardest gigs in the world. Mm. Please, let me just let you know that, okay? Yeah. Because everybody's just gonna compare you, stand there, and if you wanna change it around, you can't. Whereas the American National Anthem, which I sang for the baseball last year, or this year, it was wonderful because they said, how would you like to do it? A cappella. So if I sing an a cappella, which means no music, I can go wherever I choose to go respectfully with the song, right? Mm. It's just one of those really hard gigs. And he's not a bogan.
No,
Shannon's wonderful. And I just think everybody's got an opinion. I just think that's so mean. Yeah. And he's, see, what people don't realize is he's going to read that. And he's going to be so cut. Mm. He's going to be so choked. First of all, you know, all over straight, embraced him. Now they just want to kick him whenever you...
Well, you know him better than anyone, because you were on the first, series of Australian Idol. You were there.
But I know Shannon's a very sensitive Virgo man.
Yeah.
And he's going to be really hurt by this. Yeah. And I think it's not fair. And it didn't... He looked presentable.
Yeah. That's great.
Okay, and also, you weren't standing there. I'm a great believer. If you're going to criticize something, you better get up there and be able to do it better.
Yep.
As well, or if not better.
Yeah,
that's the one. Yeah.
It's absolutely right. And what people don't realise, though, the history is replete with absolute disasters of stadium performance. I think Meatloaf at the AFL Grand Final.
Oh, we won't go there. Don't mention the war. No.
But when you've got the thing, is firstly you can hardly hear yourself or the music
at all.
And I
don't know what he was
and
hearing.
Getting,
you see?
That's right.
You
know, and
you're getting
working,
a delay.
You're getting an echo.
It's over.
Yeah.
You know, and what do? You can't stop. Say stop.
That's right.
You just have to keep going.
Sport just can bring out the best, but also just the worst in people, huh?
Yes, it can.
You know,
yes,
it's just some narky people sitting behind their keyboards on a Saturday afternoon.
Having nothing
to do. Are you doing? You know, are you standing up?
Well,
in
you
front
get
of
up
crowd?
There and sing it.
Exactly.
What are they doing tweeting when they should be spending all their money on the horses?
Feedback coming in on this. We have this from Tony. Nothing wrong with it. He's not an opera singer and shouldn't be judged as one. Good on you,
Tony.
Thanks, Tony. And this one. I thought it sounded all right. All the knockers, you get up and sing it in front of everyone. I bet it will be off key.
Exactly.
Words missing. Too critical. She's using Mark Holden as her...
Don't mention that war either, OK?
What is with the freaking clown?
Terrifying.
Yeah. Send in the clowns.